look at another Bali variation. It's a very famous one, and it is one of the Black Swan variations. Now, there are two variations, and depending on the ballet company, they will do one or the other. So as you know, these variations are always my own choreography, but I do take inspiration from usually the Royal Ballet variations. And all of the variations are always on demi-point, so you don't need point shoes to do these. So today, as we are going to be Odile, we need to bring a little bit of that kind of character to the variation. So obviously, I'm just gonna go through all the steps first of all, but then once you've got the steps, remember to bring a little bit of like diva to the role. So we're going to start the variation in classical position, and it's a very, very short introduction, and we're going to extend to first arabesque and tendu derrière on the first count. Come into plié, preparatory position for a pirouette, and you can keep the arms straight or you can bring them rounded, whatever you prefer. And then we're going to do one pirouette en dehors, and finish in attitude. Things to think about for this pirouette are that we don't want, as we're coming from the passé into the attitude, as we're going to finish, we don't want to be bringing it out to the side. As soon as possible, we want to be crossing that round foot to the opposite shoulder. You can do a high attitude, or you can keep it a bit lower. Now, you have two options here. Either you can lower onto a straight leg, which is obviously more difficult, but it keeps the line much longer. So it's up to you if you want to lower onto a straight leg or if you want to lower onto a plié. Completely up to you. Obviously, lowering onto a straight leg is a bit more difficult, but it keeps the line longer. So, from the beginning, we have preparatory position, tendu, and pirouette, attitude. So from the attitude, we're coming up, up, and relevé. And the arms, I'm going from our attitude, we're coming to second position, first, and fifth. Then, from our fifth, we're going to do the swan arms. Now, what's really important for the swan arms is that we lift the elbows. It's not about dropping the elbows and straightening them, drop straight. It's about lifting the elbows every time. So it starts from here, from the shoulder and from the elbow. We don't want to be doing this. We want up and up and up and up from the elbow. So from here, we've stepped up, we're gonna stay on relevé, and we're gonna do one, two, three, a big one, to come down to brava, fifth position, and start again on the other side. So, tendu, pirouette preparation, and attitude, up, up, and fifth, swan arms, and a big one. From here, we've done our last swan arms, and we come, soutenu, fifth, stop, soutenu, fifth, stop. Pick up that front foot, leave the head and the shoulder, and walk round, 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 ready for the next section. So let's just try that section of music. And up, plié, and détourné. Now with the arms, we're going to bring the arms up, prepare third position. Now we're coming second position and then fifth position, détourné with the arms in first. And one, two, and three, and four. So those are the counts for that, it's quite fast. So we finish our détourné here and we're going to step out into arabesque and come through. The feet for that are arabesque. You can keep this low, no problem at all. And we're going to bring it through, bayé through. And the arms are first arabesque and then bring it round into fourth arabesque. We're going to bring this arm down, bring the back arm over, and just a little breathe there as we curry back. Ready to start on the other side. And prepare. Fuerte, détourné. And this time, we're just going to do a little tourlevé in arabesque. Keep it small if you want, or you can do a bigger one. And we're going to run to this corner. Ready to start the next section. And one, two, and three, and four. Arabesque, five, six, seven, eight, and one, two, and three, and four. Tourlevé, five, six, run, seven, and eight. So let's try that section with the music up to there. And attitude, head to the front, up, up, fifth, Swan arms, big, and again to the other side, attitude, one, two, and three. This time we're going to release that back leg and come to the front corner. So after we've repeated just that first part, we don't have the underdone pirouettes this time. So from here we're coming and we're doing the same as we did on the diagonal, but we're doing it in a manege this time. So we're doing it in a big circle basically. So we're coming. Seesaw, double play, relevé, double play, double play, double play. And again, this time move it back and up and double play, double play, double play, double play. From there, we are going straight into piqués en dedans. Now you can do this in coup de pied or you can do it in retiré, whichever you prefer. So we're doing five chassé and finish. So we've got our double loads. One, two, three. One, two, three, four, five. Chassé, arms in fifth, and down. You need a big room for this one, but after the last pique, we're just going to, from here, chassé, arms to fifth, and down. Looking over that front hand.
I'm just gonna do it once through. I'm gonna put on my tutu just for fun, and remember that you don't have to be in pointe shoes to be able to dance in a tutu. And you're going to dance it for something, please let me know, because it makes me so happy to know that you guys have like learnt the choreography and have enjoyed it. You can also tag me on Instagram if you're going to film it. I'll leave all of my Instagram details below. But thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you for the next variation. Bye guys.